Random event, probability of failure and failure rate. What is the random event? Random event is reliability engineering means random failure, which is the predicted chance or average event, not a specific event in specific time. Due to, in fact, they are limitation of the statistic operating time, or some variables are not completely understood. The predictions are based on statistically data gathered from a large number of source and variety conditions. So random failure event or time of failure event often cannot be precisely predicted. Random events are classified into the two types. The first, discrete variable when certain value is available, and second one, continuous value from the calculated numerical value within a range. Why is the importance of the random event? The random events or random variable related to the probability density function or PDF, PX, or probability of getting a value, and further to consider about the cumulative distribution function or CDF in reliability engineering. Anyhow, the basic mathematical property of the probability is summation of on probability. It means sigma of on probability shall be equal to 1 for discrete value, and for continuous value, the integral of on probability density function shall be equal to the 1 same as per the below equation. Cumulative distribution function, or CDF, is represent the cumulative probability of getting a value in interval time, which is the probability of the failure, PF, in process safety engineering. So it is the integral of probability density function, which means the area under the PDF curve accumulate up to the present value, as per this figure. However, in the reliability engineering, there are several to represent the CDFs, such as the normal distribution, exponential distribution, log normal distribution, Weibull distribution, gamma distribution, and etc. Typically, to use with the type of the distribution is depend on the area of the concern. Exponential distribution is generally used for the non-repeatable system. Normal distribution is generally used for the high stress component or in the science area of concern. Log normal distribution is generally used for the repeatable system. The below is a represent curve of the probability density function and cumulative density function of several kinds of distribution, such as the exponential distribution, normal distribution, and log normal distribution. How to estimate the probability of the failure? The most use of the distribution in the process safety engineering is the exponential distribution. So the probability density function of the exponential distribution is Ft equal to the k e order by minus kt for time more than zero, and equal to zero for time less than zero. And cumulative density function is represented by capital Ft, is calculated by the integrate of them, and we can get 1 minus epsilon order by minus kt. K is a constant value in viewpoint of the process safety engineering. This is represented by the failure rate or lambda. So the equation of the cumulative density function or probability of the failure PF will be probability of a failure equal to 1 minus epsilon order by minus lambda t for time more than 0. The below is the picture represent the probability density function curve and cumulative density function curve. The maximum cumulative density function will reach at 1 at the end. What is the failure rate? From the above equation, the probability density is directly rely on the failure rate or lambda. Failure rate is the typical defined as a fails to perform its intended function. In fact, failure is classified into two categories. First one, random failure, and second one, systematic failure. The random failure is the actual physical failure, such as the equipment failure by stress. It's different with the systematic failure, which is not actual physical equipment failure during normal operation, but it is some kind of the functional failure. Typically, systematic failure is hidden failure and cause of the failure occur before the operation. The example of the systematic failure, such as the incorrect logic diagram software crash, that shall be correct during the system commissioning or system testing. The picture below is the Bartter curve that represents the life cycle of electronic part. You can see failureless often is called as a hazardless. Failureless is separated into the three regions. First one, infant mortality. Second one, useful life. And third one, wear out zone. The reliability engineering, the failureless that is used in calculation is failureless in useful life or constant failureless. The other region, such as the infant mortality, will be removed during the commissioning or startup phase. How to calculate the failure rate? For discrete value sets, the instantaneous failure rate is calculated from the number of the failure per unit of time divided from the total quantity of the component exposed to the failure. However, the actual record of the failure rate is doing during the plant is operation is called time-dependent failure rate. The difference with the above basic formula is total quality of the export or survival units is all the time reducing based on the time increasing. So the time dependent failure rate is the ratio of the changing number of the failure unit during the time period and the number of the survival multiplied with the time difference between each failure. For above equation, it means some of the number unit is still alive during the collecting the data. For conservative calculation is in the reliability engineering, on sample shall be taken into account, into the calculation. Typically, it is assumed that for the survival unit, will at least 1 more hour can be operated. Then, on the sampling, will be taken into account for calculation the failure rate. The below is the sample of the calculation. You can see the time-dependent failure rate. The item number 7 to number 10 are assumed to be failure during the 1,801 hours. This is the picture and calculated of the average failure rate. Thank you for watching my video, and let's see you on next video. Bye bye.